Dear friends, welcome. I hope you are having a wonderful day. In this session, we are going to discuss about the electronic payment system in retail. Traditional payment system. In the traditional payment system in retail, there are two modes of payment, cash and credit. Cash is one of the most acceptable hassle-free system of payment in POS. The reason behind the most dominant form of payment are lack of trust in the banking system, inefficient clearing and settlement of non-cash transaction, negative real interest rates paid on bank deposit. Payment by cash and check are not possible in purchase through e-commerce site. But in face-to-face retail, only few retailers accept checks. There are certain limitations. Let's look into the limitation. In the traditional retail system, there is a risk of carrying money to the stores. Now, customers have started using the comfort by using plastic currency like debit, credit or specific store value cards. Traditional, that is non-electronic payment method such as cash, checks and money orders are rapidly vanishing from modern retail market. Cash and checks cannot be used in purchase through e-commerce as there is no face-to-face contact. Major issuers of credit cards and payment brands are pressing retailers worldwide to accept cards at their checkout counters. There are innovative ways of payment system for customers such as swiping, proximity, mobile and fingers. Now, we will discuss further about electronic payment system with respect to retail sales and e-commerce transactions. The important aspect of the e-commerce is prompt and secure payment, clearing and settlement of their credit and debit claims. The emerging electronic payment technology was known as electronic fund transfer. The transfer of funds initiated through an electronic terminal, a telephone instrument, a computer or a magnetic tape as to order, instruct or authorize a financial institution to debit or credit an account. The future of payment at a retail counter lies within the categories such as digital token base, credit cards, smart cards, biometrics, proximity cards, short messaging services, people to people payment. Digital token based system. To meet the challenges of growing retail and e-commerce, new form of financial instructions are being developed. One such instrument is e-token in the form of e-cash and e-checks. Electronic tokens are backed by bank. E-cash. E-cash is a new concept and used mainly in online payment system. Since payment on cash cannot be made in the net, people are looking for a privacy, find e-cash a better option. It combines computerized convenience with security and privacy that improve on paper cash. E-cash focus on replacing the currency as a major payment mechanism in consumer-oriented retail. Working of e-cash. E-cash is based on cryptographical system known as digital signature. Digital signatures are used in a big way for application other than payments. This method involves a pair of numerical keys that are very large integers. One key is used for locking or encoding, while another is used for decoding. The encoding key is kept private by the bank, but the decoding key is made public. The bank supplies the public key to the customer. Before e-cash can be used for transaction, it has to be bought from the currency server of the bank. It involves two steps: opening an account with the bank, maintaining sufficient funds in the bank to make the purchase. Some banks allow customer to buy e-cash by paying in hard currency. The customer uses a software package in his or her computer to generate a random number which serves as the note. The customer emails this note to the bank. In the exchange of the money debited from the customer account, the bank digitally signs the note for the amount requested and transmits the note back to the customer. This method of note generation is very secure as either the customer nor the vendor can duplicate the digitally signed note. E-cash can be completely anonymous, which ensures that one can spend the money freely on anything without risk of disclosing the sources of destination. E-cash must have the four properties: monetary value, interoperability, irrevocability, and security. What are e-checks? E-checks are similar to paper checks, mostly used in wholesale business or B2B transactions. They work similarly pretty manner a regular check. We will discuss the modality of how e-check works. The customer should have an e-check account with the bank. They should have the facility to accept and honor e-checks. The customer makes purchase at any retailers or e-commerce site and emails are encrypted. Electronic check. The merchant then deposits the check with the bank. The server in the bank then verifies the authenticity of the check and signature on it. The money is debited from the buyer's account and credited to the seller's account. E-checks are like regular checks, carrying signature in digital format, which can be verified. Properly signed and endorsed e-checks are exchanged between financial institutions through e-clearing systems. The next one, credit cards. Use of credit cards have evolved as the most favored mode of payment in the retail, both in the storefront and web-based. As per the recent survey, 68% of the retail purchase in India are settled through credit cards. This is because credit card is the most convenient way of carrying money without risk of possessing money. Users of credit card also get their payment deferred till the card settlement is received from the bank. Credit card is a plastic card with a magnetic strip or a smart chip on it, which contains information about the cardholder, card number, validity, expiry, date, etc. When the customer makes a payment by the credit card, the vendor swipes the card through the dial-up modem. The terminal is provided by the bank. The modem connects with the bank server and sends the credit card information to the bank server. If the card details are genuine, the server accepts the card and sends an approval number, which is printed on the approval slip on an integrated printer with the modem. The amount is paid to the vendor by the bank. Smart cards. Smart cards are plastic cards in which chips are embedded. These cards are fast gaining acceptance as mode of payment. Smart card is also called integrated circuit card with embedded integrated circuit. There are two broad categories of smart card: memory card and microprocessor cards. Memory card contains only non-volatile memory storage components. On the other hand, microprocessor card contains both memory and microprocessor components. The standard perception of the smart card is a microprocessor card of credit card dimension with various tamper resistant properties. It possesses secure crypto processor, secure file system, human readable data, and is capable of providing security services confidentially to the information in the memory. The host computer and the card reader actually communicate with the microprocessor. The microprocessor provides access to the data on the card. The host computer reads and writes into the smart card memory. Smart cards with contactless interface becomes increasingly popular for payment and ticketing application like mass transit. Smart cards are also being introduced in personal identification and entitlement schemes at regional and national level. Citizen cards, driver's license and patient card schemes are becoming more prevalent, and contactless smart cards are being integrated into passport to enhance security for international travel. There are two types of smart cards: contact smart cards and contactless smart cards. Contact smart cards have a small gold chip about 1/2 inch diameter on the front. When inserted into the reader, the chip makes a contact with the electrical connectors that can read information from the chip and write information back. The cards do not contain batteries. The energy is supplied by the card readers. In the contactless smart card, the chip communicates with the card reader through RFID induction technology. These cards require only close proximity to an antenna to complete transaction. They are often used when transaction must be processed quickly on hands-free or mass transit system, where smart cards can be used without even removing from their wallet. Applications of smart cards. The application of smart card include their use as payment system in retail, debit or ATM card, SIM for mobile phones, authorization cards for DTH, iSecurity identification card and access control cards. The card reader, which also works as a writing device on the smart chip, can update information on the card. Beside the payment system, smart cards are used for customer loyalty program. The customer purchase reward points are loaded into the smart card at the EPOS terminal. These points are later used for getting discounts and buying new products. What are the disadvantages? The major drawback of the smart card is that they are costlier than magnetic strip cards. Another problem of the smart card is the failure rate. The plastic card in which the chip is embedded is fairly flexible, and the larger the chip, the higher probability of breaking. Smart cards are often carried in the wallets or pockets, which is fairly harsh environment for the chip. The next type is biometrics. Magnetic stripes and smart cards are widely used payment system. They are not very secure. If they are lost, they can be used by proxies. Need of more secure transaction system leads to biometrics. Use of fingerprint and personal identification is going to become common in coming years. Biometrics is an automated method of recognizing a person based on his or her physical or behavioral characteristics such as face, fingerprints, hand geometry, handwriting, iris, retina, vein, and voice. Biometric-based solutions are able to provide for confidential financial transaction and personal data privacy. Technologies that are used in biometrics. The customer should register at an in-store secure kiosk where he or she will provide credit card information. The credit card information would be attached to the customer fingerprint image. At checkout, the customer would place his or her finger on the scanner and the appropriate credit card information would be pulled out. This saves the customer from disclosing the credit card information again and again. The recent study reveals that 20% of the time for processing cost is saved due to biometrics. In the banking system, biometrics can be used to encash checks. After the person identification information is entered, the teller takes the person's picture and scans the finger into the system. The customer enters the 10-digit code that enables the system for finger scan verification. The customer can encash the check simply by scanning the finger and having the check scanned by the cashier. What are the advantages of biometric? Retailers prefer the system that are less prone to fraud. Uniqueness is how separates one individual from others. Permanent resist aging. Collectability in the ease of acquisition of measurement. Performance is the accuracy, speed, robustness of the technology used. Acceptability is the degree of approval of technology. Circumvention is the ease of use of a substitute. Proximity technology. So far, we have discussed on various payment technologies that are electronic and need contact with the reader. This kind of payment processing takes some time at the payment counter in retail and high-end speed transit exits. To overcome this delay, a new technology evolved. This is comprehensive contactless payment system built on near field communication NFC technology. This refers to the system in which reader equipment reads the signal from a distance. With proximity technology embedded into it, just swiping a mobile phone across the reader may turn into transactional tool. The recent survey suggests the cell phone as the next logical progression in proximity payment technology. Working of proximity enabled payment system. This technology enables contactless payments by the wave of a cellular phone or a card having proximity technology embedded to it. The NFC application allow consumers to store credit card and debit card information in their cell phone or specially built proximity cards. Then the customer can select a preferred method of payment at the time of transaction. The application is stored in the contactless chip inside the mobile phone. The phone is embedded with GPRS or RFID enabled chip component, connects with the nearest tower and exchange information. The payment is made and the transaction is completed. Cell phone has become the support to these new features. Technology experts anticipate proximity payment will soon be added to cell phone as they become equipped with near field communication technology. Instead of carrying different types of card, the cell phone will be used to settle transactions. Cell phone manufacturers are experimenting on security options and hardware modification to handle fingerprint and voice authentication. Cell phone settlement is expected to become popular as the next generation consumer who are already cell phone dependent and dominate the marketplace. Some of the demerits of the proximity payment are hardware and software capability on the cell phone handset. Since the proximity software resides on the handset, it will be difficult to change the handset frequently by the customer. Switching the operator would be like losing a wallet that would have an impact in the payment system. Transmitting the payment information via cell phone to a POS terminal is a cause of concern. Cell phone settlement is the threat of misplacing or losing the handset. Security concerns point for the better authentication methodologies including voice, fingerprint built into the phone so that lost equipment is rendered unusable. Short messaging services. Looking at the disadvantages of the proximity enabled cell phone as a payment tool, we have another way of using the cell phone for making the payment. Technology experts and business enthusiasts have come up with short messaging services. SMS can be used for making the payment. Bankers, network operators and retailers have come together to offer a text message based payment program to the customer. Unlike the near field communication used in the proximity method of payment, this requires a handset equipped with NFC short range radio. This program will let every cell phone user complete retail transaction from their phones. The SMS payment system mechanism is a futuristic technology. Presently, there are two ways in which systems are supposed to work: bank way, credit card way. As the technology matures, more refinement in the system and better service will be provided to the customer. Bank way. There are four parties involved in the system. They are customer, retailer, bank and mobile service provider. The customer has to register with the bank for using SMS based payment system. For example, the customer walks into a shop, selects an item and proceeds to the EPOS for payment. The customer should tell the cashier that he needs to pay through SMS. Both the customer and the retailer have bank accounts. The seller sends a payment request to the buyer with text message. The buyer then keys in a PIN to approve the sale and send a response to the seller's SMS. Once the transaction completes, both parties receive an SMS receipt. The money is transferred from customer account to the retailer account. Credit card way. In this method, there is an involvement of third party bill pay company. The customer needs to register with the bill pay company that can be done through mobile phone or the website of the company. While registering through mobile phone, the customer is required to enter a 4-digit PIN. The PIN is confidential password to authenticate all transactions. The mobile number is also registered with the company. The second step, the customer needs to register the credit card with the company, which goes to the secure database of the company. This is one-time activity where the customer need not disclose the credit card number with every purchase. While registering through the website of the company, the customer needs to register the mobile phone number and credit card number. The customer will receive an automated PIN from the bill pay company to the registered mobile number of the customer. This temporary PIN can later be changed for security reasons. Making the payment with the registered mobile, the customer sends an SMS on his registered mobile to a particular number with the amount of payment. The customer authenticates the payment with PIN. The payment is made only through register mobile and by the valid PIN. It seems to be secure and the payment made comes into the customer next and credit card system. Advantages of SMS based payment. It is convenient. It is useful. All the utility bills can be paid at one time. It is safe. Once registered, customer need not enter the credit card information on the web again. All transactions are controlled by PIN. The disadvantages of the SMS based system is that the transaction takes 18 seconds. As a tool, it is meant to replace the cash and is not saving time. People to people payment system. In the people to people payment system, one person pays on behalf of the other. Both payer and the payee must be registered with the middle person or service provider. The prominent among the P2P service provider is PayPal. In this system of payment, a person can make payment to any other person having an email ID. Both the payer and the receiver should have an email ID and to be registered with the service provider like PayPal. The payers need not divulge information of credit card to the vendor or the payee. This information of credit card is given only to the PayPal while registering with it. The selling point in using such P2P services automatically encrypts all the sensitive information sent between the user computer and the service provider. The system verifies the user internet browser is running in an SSL, that is Secure Socket Layer 3.0 or higher version. While in transit, the information is protected by SSL with an encryption key length of 128 bits. The servers at the PayPal's are highly secure with firewalls. What are the advantages of the P2P services? It's faster than sending checks or money orders. Payments are instantly debited to credit card account. It is very safe and prevents fraud and helps the payer and the receiver safe. Financial information is kept private and secure. Payment can be made locally or anywhere worldwide. Services of a service provider like PayPal are accepted globally by the retailers. So, what did we learn in today's session? With all round growth in organized retail, there has been a paradigm shift in way payment is made at the retail counter. Besides credit card, newer and technological advancement such as e-cash, e-checks, biometric, proximity cards, smart cards, short messaging services and person-to-person systems were discussed in detail and the technology changes accepted both by the customer and the vendors. That is all for today. I hope you have enjoyed the session. Thank you.